What's going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is Darian with Darian the Dev, and in this video we're going to talk about why you should enjoy being a junior developer while you can. If you guys are new to the channel, if you're into tech, entrepreneurship, coding, startups, anything like that, make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. That's basically all we talk about here on this channel. And it really just helps me stay motivated to keep making this content for you guys. This video is going to be a little different. I'm kind of going to do a reaction to another YouTuber. His name is Chris Hawks. He's got a lot of great software developer content, and he's been in the game, the software developer world, for like 10 plus years. So I know he's a senior developer and he's got a lot of experience on his channel. I just haven't personally like watched a ton of his content, but this video popped up. And it was called Enjoy Being a Junior Programmer. And I thought that was a really interesting title. So I kind of just wanted to like do a reaction a little bit and just give you guys a little bit of perspective on my opinion about what he's saying. Because I thought he made some really good points.
Today is one of those days where I'm just kind of tired. And I'm like, I've been coding a lot lately. And I think I'm just a little bit tired. But I looked at a job post the other day. It was on Stack Overflow. The job description, it was for a lot of money. It was like for like 140 to 180 or something like that. So they're looking for like a senior React guy or girl. And they had this humongous description. I'll have to like share it if I can find the link again. But in the description of the job, it was like, you prefer to, you know, eat pizza at home while coding versus going out. And like, it just listed all these different things that like, essentially, somebody with absolutely no life whatsoever except for code. And that's who they're looking for. They're looking for somebody that, like, is gonna, you know, be destined at some point to wake up and be like, holy shit, what did I do in my entire life? So
first off, as we can already see, I already agree from the experiences I've seen working as a developer with what he's saying. So a lot of the senior developers that I've seen or I've been around in the industry since I've been working as a developer, they do have a lot on their plate. Like, they spend a lot of hours, usually outside of work, still working on work-related things. So even if it's like production issues or teaching, you know, junior or younger, even mid-level developers, the senior developers that I've seen, they always have a ton of work to do, like outside of their own responsibilities and just being expected to implement a lot of business requirements and just write a ton of code and also maintain it and document it and write tests around it. A lot of times they have to still deploy things and then maintain it if it breaks or if anything happens or if something changes. They have to maintain all that stuff. And then if a new developer comes along, they also have to train that developer and teach that developer and mentor that developer or developers, because it could be more than one that come onto the team. What he's saying, I thought that was a really, you know, interesting perspective, because it's, wow, I think for a lot of people, becoming a senior developer is like a really big goal. And I'm guilty of this too. It's important to really think about what your end goal is and what type of work-life balance you want to have and the reason why you got into tech.
At the same time, I look at some of these job descriptions and I'm like, man, I'm kind of stuck. You know, you're stuck as a senior dev. You're going to make about the same amount no matter where you go once you get up to a certain level. When you're fresh out of school, you're new into this industry, and you have a lot of upward trajectory in your salary and you're just getting started. But software development is very front-loaded in the salary field, which means that you're going to make about the peak of what you're going to make pretty damn quick.
I thought was really interesting about this point that he just made was that he's at the point now where he's gonna make, as a senior developer, basically the same thing no matter where he goes. And obviously I'm not a senior developer, so I don't know what that really is. I'm guessing it's probably anywhere between 150 and like 250, maybe 300,000 if you're at like a really big company. I mean, I'm sure that's like a ton of money, and some people out there are probably just like, yo, how much money do you want? How much money do you need? And you know, I'm sure everyone's different. Everyone has different goals and things like that. But you know, the point is still that you're limited. There's still gonna be a ceiling, and at some point the workload is not gonna change. It's probably, if anything, gonna only increase if you know, switch jobs as a senior developer. Your workload is not gonna get easier or more laid back anywhere else. It's still gonna be pretty heavy, pretty drastic. And I think that's his point. but he's still going to make pretty much the same money. I just think he's given a really interesting perspective to what the other side of getting really good and years of experience as a developer looks like.
And, when you continue to work for the company, which is what most of us do, you get up to that peak level where you can't really go any further. And eventually, after, doing that 5-10 years or whatever, you start to see some pretty prevalent burnout in this industry, just people that just are not motivated
Yeah, so here he mentions like getting burnt out and developers not having the motivation to learn any of the new technology that's coming out because they're burnt out. Like there's no benefit left for them. There's no promotion or no raises really left for them that is gonna give them a reason to change the way they currently think or the current way that they do things, you know what I mean? And so on one hand, that is what gives us as the new entry-level developers who have that hunger and motivation and desire to just learn, that's what gives us the advantage, is because we have so many developers, who might be, just really far into their career and who are just tired and just burnt out and ultimately just basically coded out. I think some people have just already decided that they're just trying to, get on with it. And the new wave of developers that are coming through the boot camps and doing the Udemy courses and the free code camps and the self-teaching online and things like that, I think we're the ones who are coming along and picking up all these new technologies, and we're going to literally write the code of the future. Like, we're going to set the new standards and be the mid-level developers of tomorrow and the senior level developers of tomorrow. And so it's important to kind of listen to things like this so that we can kind of decide what type of future we want in this industry. Do you want to be that person who is constantly pulled in 10, 15, 20 different directions all the time and possibly on call all the time to put out fires and mentor others and all those things? Like, is code really your life to that extent? Or do you just want to gain all the skills that come with, being a really good developer that you can go do your own, startup or side business or be an entrepreneur or whatever on the side? So I just wanted to make this video, guys, to give you guys some perspective on what he was saying, because I thought he really made some interesting points. We're only like halfway through the video, but I'm already at like 15 something minutes in this video, so I'm gonna have to edit this down. But I just really thought this was interesting. I thought he gave some really good points, and I wanted to share some opinions on what he was saying and give you guys just something to think about, just some little food for thought. So I hope this was helpful or valuable to you guys. If it was, let me know down in the comment section down below if you guys have any questions or any comments about anything. Let's chat it up down in the comment section down below. Also, guys, check out my description box down below where I'm giving out my free intro to coding bootcamp course for anybody who's like brand new to coding or just getting into it or thinking about going to a coding bootcamp. I put everything I wish I knew going into coding bootcamp in there. So it's got a front end project that you'll build in there. You'll learn the basics of back end and all that good stuff. So it's a great course. It costs nothing but your email address. So make sure you guys go and check that out in the description box down below. Also in the description box, you guys will see the private Facebook group where I go and add all the links and all the stuff that I don't add in the description box to these videos. So go over there and make sure you guys get added into the Facebook group as well. So until next time, guys, this is Darian with Darian the Dev. I'll see you guys in the next video. All right, peace.